Hello, Luke here. I hope you all had a fantastic week so far. In this video, we're going to use Chocolatey to install SQL Server 2022 Developer Edition along with Management Studio, and then we're going to actually patch the instance and then download and restore the Wide World Importers DW database to the new instance. Let's go ahead and get started. I am on my host machine for my sandbox. I'm going to go ahead and start SRV1, which is the machine that we're going to be installing SQL Server on. It is a Windows Server 2022 standard edition VM, and I am using the evaluation copy. So we have it booted up. I'll go ahead and log in here. And we'll jump into add remove programs just so that you can see I don't currently have SQL Server installed. So the only thing we've got installed are a few updates and VMware tools. First step is we're going to go ahead and open up Windows PowerShell ISE as an admin. And then we just have a few commands I'm going to paste in here. Let's go ahead and clean this screen up, go to full screen. The first step, set execution policy bypass this line here. We're going to actually install Chocolatey using this script, the install.ps1 out on chocolatey.org. If you're not familiar with what Chocolatey is, it's a package manager for Windows, similar to Yum or Brew if you're on a Mac, very similar. So let's go ahead and run this line. We can either click here, run selection, or you can hit F8 on your keyboard. So Chocolatey is installed. Now we're ready to download and install SQL Server 2022 using this command. Go ahead and highlight it and then press that button. This takes a few minutes. While we wait, if you're interested in creating your own sandbox, I do have a three-step guide to walk you through that process of some of the components that are required to set up Home Lab. I'll put the link down in the description if you want to check that out. So the ISO has downloaded, and now you'll see in a second that Chocolatey will mount that ISO. There it is. And then Chocolatey started the installation. These commands will be on the blog post associated with this video so that you can grab those and run through the setup yourself. All right, so the installation is complete. We're now ready to download the latest update. And today that is Community of Update 10 for SQL Server 2022. So we'll just highlight that line and run that selection. It's going to open up your default browser and download that update. And once it's complete, we'll just run it manually. Should be in your downloads folder. Just go ahead and double click on it and go through the wizard. And you can delete that file once the update has been installed. Accept the license terms, click next, next. You can go ahead and skip the file check and then click update and it will start the update. All right, the update completed. You can go ahead and close out of the wizard. Again, if you want to delete that file, you can. Next step is to install SQL Server Management Studio. This step will also install Azure Data Studio. Let's go ahead and highlight that line and run the selection. That installation has completed. There's one more step we need to do before we jump into Management Studio. Actually, two more steps. Let's go ahead and download the Wide World Importers DW backup file. That's just a sample database that Microsoft has created. There's a few other copies that you can grab of Wide World Importers. You can do a Google search and should be able to find those pretty easily. We're going to go ahead and download this one. Should just open up the browser and download this backup file. So that's finished. You can close out of the browser. This step is going to create SQL sample databases. It's going to create that directory on the C drive, and that's where we need to copy that BAK file. So go ahead and just create that. Now we're going to go into downloads, grab this BAK file and move it. So you can use cut and jump into this directory, SQL sample databases, and just paste it there. Next step is to open up SQL Server Configuration Manager, and that's under Start, Microsoft SQL Server 2022, and then SQL Server 2022 Configuration Manager. Click on SQL Server Services. I'm going to go ahead and change this SQL Server Agent Startup mode from manual to automatic. So in this window, click on Service. Start mode should be automatic. That's just so if you've got any jobs that you want to create and schedule, anytime that SQL Server restarts or the server restarts, the agent will also run. Go ahead and start it. And then one more step, under SQL Server Network Configuration, go ahead and expand that. And then on protocols for MS SQL Server, TCP/IP is currently disabled, so if you were to try to access this instance from one of your other machines in your sandbox, you wouldn't be able to. So let's go ahead and enable that by right-clicking and saying OK. So that setting won't take effect until you restart the SQL Server service. So let's go ahead and restart it. If you have Windows Firewall running, you would need to add a firewall rule for port 1433, since this is a default instance and that's the default port. But we're not going to do that as part of this video. All right, so we can close it out of SQL Server Configuration Manager, jump into Management Studio, and connect to your server name, whatever that server name is. Mine is SRV1. We didn't install a named instance. Again, we just installed a default instance. And you can see there's no databases. We have the SQL Server agent running. You can tell by this green arrow. Go ahead and click on SRV1, right click, and choose New Query. We're going to go ahead and restore that backup file. Let me go ahead and grab this statement here. So the first step is we're going to run restore database, Wide World Importers DW from disk. This is our backup file with stats equals 10. So that means as the restore progresses, every 10%, it's going to show us under the messages tab here. just gives you a status update of as that restore is progressing. All right, we can see that that was successful. We'll go over here to databases and click refresh, and you should have a new database here. If you go ahead and expand that database and then expand tables, you'll see a lot of different tables. This is a warehouse or a data warehouse. So you'll see facts and dimensions. And then if we run this statement here, this use wide world importers DW, you'll see a switch from master to being inside that database, and we can run select star from fact.movement. See how we switched from master to that database context, and we ran our statement. So that's it in a nutshell. You should have SQL Server Developer Edition installed, Management Studio installed, and Azure Data Studio if you want to use it. It is here as well. If you like this video, go ahead and like and subscribe. If you'd like to see more like this, go ahead and comment below. And I am interested to see just how you're going to use this. Are you going to use it to look at new features in SQL Server Developer Edition or SQL Server 2022 Developer Edition, or using it to restore your own database and do some development work, or maybe you're using it to learn T-SQL. But anyway, thanks a lot for stopping by, and I'll catch you in the next video.